these objects of enjoyment, tadusham, maharajana vastrobhavam, then also mind becomes like the cloth, which is color. Vasana rupam ranjanakaram utpadyate chittasya tadusham ranjanakaram. Ranjanakaram ragatmakam. Raga means color. So, mind also gets colored. Just as the cloth, when it comes in contact with turmeric, etc., gets colored, so also mind, when it comes in contact with objects, gets colored. So, ranjanakaram utpadyate chittasya. The chitta of the mind, as that kind of a color arises in the mind also. Yena ranjanena, because of which coloring? Asau purushaha raktahiti uchyate. So we say that this purusham is the mind, is colored. Vastradivata. So just as when the cloth comes in contact with turmeric, how the cloth gets colored, so also when the mind comes in contact with various objects, the mind also gets colored, and therefore we say that this person is colored. And so these different examples of colors are given to illustrate different moods of the mind, how the mind gets influenced differently depending upon what it comes in contact with, and so forth. We will continue with that tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Vadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om Sarupam Yatha Maharajanam Vasaha Yatha Pandvavikam Yatha Indra Gopaha Yathagnyarchihe Yathapundarikam Yathasakradvidyuttam Sakradvidyutteva hava asya shrir bhavate Ya evam veda Athata adeshah Neti neti Nahyetasmadite Netyanyat paramaste Athanama dheyam Satyasya satyamide Pranavai satyam Teshamesha satyam. Tasya etasya purushasya rupam. This is the form, the nature of that purusha who is established to be the subtle body. So these are the different moods of the mind. That's what it means. So going to page 563. The question was, Nanu anyasyeva adeshaha natu vijnanamayasyeti. When it says neti neti, why should we imagine that is only said about the Atma? Why not we say that it is said about Brahma, that is different from Atma? The answer was no. Shasthande upasamharad vijnataramare kena vijaniyadidi. Sesha neti neti Atma. Thus, in the fourth chapter, when this Maitri Brahmana is concluded, it is said very clearly, neti neti Atma. So Atma is not this, not this. Vijnataramare ken vijaniyat. How can one know the knower? And therefore, there, the negation of all the vishesha or all the attributes is very clearly with reference to Atma. And therefore, it should be with reference to Atma here alone, because the trend is similar. And also the promise was made that I'm going to teach you about Brahma, and that promise will be fulfilled only when Brahman is known as Atma. Yadicha vijnanam seva asamvyavaharyatvam atma swarupam jnapatam ishtam syat pradyastharvopad vishesham. Only when it is vijnanam, the individual self is being taught as one that is devoid of all the attributes and devoid of all limitations, tada iyam pradignya arthavadi syat, then alone this promise of teaching about Brahma would become fulfilled. Then it would become meaningful. Teaching about Brahman with whom I have nothing to do would not be a meaningful thing. Teaching about Brahman with which I have to do something, that is my very self. And therefore, knowing Brahman is knowing myself. Yenasau jnapitah janati atmanam ahameva brahma asmiti. By which teaching this one comes to know that I am Brahman. Shastra nishtham prapnoti. And that's how he gains an abidance in the vision of the Shastra. Navibhedi kutaschanedi. And becomes free from every kind of fear. So this is the result of the teaching. Then alone that promise will become meaningful. Otherwise, suppose somebody promises, I'll teach you about theory of relativity. It's fine. What is it going to accomplish for me in my life? It may be general information. Nice to know that things are like that. But here, on the other hand, one is anxious to become free from every sense of limitation and fear. And that will be accomplished only when it is Atma that is being taught, as the one that is devoid of all the visheshas, all the attributes, all the qualifications, because every qualification or every attribute in fact is nothing but a sense of limitation. And so thus Atma is revealed to be that who is free from every limitation. Atha punaha anyaha vijnanamaya anyaha neta neti iti vyapadishyate. If on the other hand the Atma is of one nature, and what is being taught is not this, not this, is Brahman, who is different from Atma. Tada anyadaha brahma anyoham asmiti. Then Brahman always remains as someone different from his paroksham. Brahman always remains as someone that is separate from me, as remote, as different from me. Anyoham asmiti. And that means I continue to know myself only as a limited being. And Brahman remains limitless. Brahman is all right, but remains someone that is different from me. Iti viparyaha grahitasya. And thus, the student would go away with a viparita jnana, meaning totally contradictory knowledge. Because that is not what the Shruti wants to teach. Atmanameva avet aham brahma asmiti. This is how the whole discussion started, Brahma Kandika, that he knew himself as Brahman. And so, aham brahma asmi is the vision that is unfolded by the Shruti. And here, on the other hand, this student will go with a vision that Brahman is different from me. And therefore, it contradicts what has been said earlier also. Tasmat tasthe tasthedi ling purushasyeva etani rupani. We can see how Bhashyakara arrives at the meaning of this different passage of the Upanishad, because the vision is very clear. Aham brahmasmi. This is what Brihadaranyaka Upanishad teaches. Tattvamasi is what Chandogya teaches. Aham Brahmasmi is what Brihadaranyaka teaches. And so that is what Lord Krishna teaches. Aham Brahmasmi. All the time he says, Aham, you know, Pitahamasya Jagadaha, Mata, Dhata, Pitamaha. I am Brahman. Maya Tadamidam Sarvam Jagadavyak Murtina. Mastani Sarabhutani, Nachaham Teshvastidaha, Nachamastani Bhutani. So he keeps on teaching all the time, I am Brahman. That requires some boldness, you know. But anyway, so he says, Aham Brahmasmi. This is what is taught throughout Bhagavad Gita. That's what this Upanishad seeks to teach. And therefore, if this particular passage or some Kandika teaches something different, it would just contradict the whole trend of the Upanishad. Tasmat tasya etasyeti linga purusha seva etani rupani. And therefore, when it's said here that etasya purushasya rupani, they are the linga purushasya rupani, meaning they are the forms or the modes of only subtle body, and not of the Atma. All right, if after all, this is, now that you interpreted the word Purusha as Linga Sharira, subtle body, Then kimiti upanyasyante, why is it necessary to tell us what are the different samskaras or different vasanas of the mind? Paramatma swarupasyaiva vaktavyatvat. Because what is to be stated or what is to be known is the nature of the self. Why should I worry about the nature of the mind? Why should one worry about knowing the nature of mind? Whereas there is necessity on my part to know the nature of the self. Satyasya cha satye paramatma swarupe vaktavye nirvashesham satyam vaktavyam. So Shruti wants to teach satyasya satyam. What is presently taken to be satyam of the truth, that there is a truth of the truth. So therefore we should also know what is presently being taken as truth. Because what is necessary there is avada. So what is presently taken to be truth is something to be negated. And then alone what is really the truth comes to be known. Therefore, dhyaropa is very necessary. And then alone apavada. Apavada can be carried out only after dhyaropa. So negation becomes meaningful only when the superimposition is understood. And therefore, this first satya that is being taught is the superimposition. That five elements of which this body is made, the gross body and the subtle body are made of five elements, which are presently taken to be atma, satyam by me. Which is okay, has some kind of a reality. We don't say that it is not atma at all. Yes, body also is atma, that's okay. But only as far as long as the waking state is concerned, that's all. When I'm in dream, this body is no more atma. So we don't say the body is anatma totally or not atma, but then its atmatvam is all vyabhichara, is all the time changing. Even subtle body is atma, okay, as long as I am in the waking and the dream state, but that is not atma when I am in deep sleep state. So satyasya satyam, that which is ever the self. Niravashesham satyam vaktavyam. And so it is necessary that the truth, which is that both the aspects must be taught, the dvaita as well as advaita. Satyasya cha vishesha rupani vasanaha. And of what is presently taken as truth, namely the mind, has all these various forms to show that it cannot be self. So what is presently taken to be the self, the mind is taken to be the self. And the Upanishad shows how the mind has all these different forms, and meaning thereby that it cannot be atma. As Indra came to know, naham bhojyam pashyami, I don't see anything worthwhile in this. So he came away with the idea that the gross body is the self, then he realized that if that is the atma, then that means that if this one becomes blind, then I become blind. This one dies and the self dies. No, this is not right. This can't be right. And then he went away with the idea that the subtle body is the self. That also did not satisfy him. And that is how it will not satisfy this person. So therefore, all these rupas are being said in order to very clearly show that this cannot be the self. Self cannot be having all these different forms. Satyasya cha visesha rupani vasanaha tasam imani rupani uchyante. And so there are many vasanas, many rupas are there, of which some of the forms are being said. It's not possible to describe all the different shades of the mind, but some of the shades are being described here. Etasya purushasya prakritasya lingatmaha eva etani rupani. And so all of these are the rupa or the shades or the colors or the forms or the samskaras or vasanas or moods of this mind with the subtle body. Kani tani yatha loke maharajanam. Maharajanam is haridra, the turmeric. Tayaraktam maharajanam. So maharajanam and tayaraktam maharajanam. So that which is colored by maharajanam. Maharajanam means turmeric. So that which is colored by turmeric is called maharajanam. Yatha vaso loke. So just as in our day-to-day experience, how the cloth gets colored by something like turmeric. Evam stryad vishaya sanyoge tadrasham vasanamayam ranjana karatam utpadyate chittasya. And similarly also, when just as the cloth comes in contact with the turmeric, how it gets dyed in a color. Similarly also, when the mind comes in contact with the various objects, then it also gets influenced by them. It also becomes dyed. Ranjanakaram utpadyate chittasya. Raga atmakam. So raga also means color. the mind gets colored naturally. The mind seems to be of the nature of the one that always gets, that comes under the spell of everything it comes in contact with. So when it comes in contact with something that is conducive, it again comes in the spell of that, and when it comes in contact with something that is not conducive, comes in spell of that also. So these are not necessarily the colors of the mind of a yogi or a wise man who is the mastery of the mind. Well, that mind will not be colored. But this is the mind of an ordinary person that gets colored by anything and everything that it comes in contact with.
Yena sau purushah rakta hiti uchyate vastra adivata.
Just as vastra becomes colored, and so also the mind becomes colored in by whatever it comes in contact with, the mind becomes colored. And that's how you can keep on pressing different switches. That's all it is. There are millions of switches inside. You press a switch and something will show up. And so sometimes red light, sometimes green light, sometimes blue light, sometimes yellow light. Imagine a bulb having this different kinds of lights, and depending on which switch you press, different kinds of lights will come out. And so also so many switches are there, buttons are there. You can push those buttons and he will show different colors. Sometimes he becomes red, sometimes he becomes blue, sometimes he becomes green. And so I just read, these colors, you bring the second TV and your first TV becomes green, you know, something like that. This is an advertisement of one television. So what is green? The green also is a color. Green means immature or young, you know. So, huh? Green is jealousy. Wow, that may be so. I was looking, but I couldn't find that. Green is jealousy. Blue is sadness, you know. So blue is, I guess, sadness or grief. Green is jealousy. And then yellow is something else. I don't know. Everything has a color. Everything has, you know. So I thought yellow was jealousy, but then green is jealousy. So anyway, so this whole person becomes green, becomes yellow, becomes blue. So this is what happens. So you need not, you know, all that is required is push some button. That's all that is to be done. Push a button, he becomes blue, and push another button, becomes green. So that is what is being shown, and that because all the potential is there in the mind.
Now continuing with on the page 564 from the third line. Yatha cha loke pandvavikam avehe idam avikam urnadi yatha cha tat panduram bhavade tatha anyadvasana rupam yatha cha loke indra gopah atyanta rakto bhavate evamasya vasana rupam kvachita visaya vishesha apekshaya ragasya taratamyam kvachita purusha chitta vritya apekshaya.
Another example, yathacha loke Pandu avikam becomes Pandu avikam. Pandu means white, avikam. Aveheidam avikam. So avi means a lamb or whatever, you know, sheep. So sheep. So aveheidam avikam. So that is pertaining to a sheep. Urnadi, like wool. So like wool or anything that is connected to the sheep is called avikam. And Pandu means white. So Pandu avikam. Like something that is connected with the white sheep, and that means white wool or something like that.
Yathachatat panduram bhavati.
So,
ranjanayana panduram bhavati tatha anyadvasana rupam.
So similarly also the mind can become white. Again, coming in contact with something, it can become white also. So satsangatve nisangatvam. Same mind when exposed to satsanga then becomes white in color, sattvic in color.
Yatha cha loke indra gopaha.
An insect called indra gopaha, which is scarlet in color, atyandarakto bhavati, is extremely red.
Evam asya vasana rupam, asya lingasya vasana rupam.
Oh, the fifth is fifth footnote, Pandvadikam. So, Pitim, Amishra Shuklam, whatever. So, Amishra Shuklam. So, that which is not Shukla, not white. So, Panduram means yellowish, looks like, you know, becomes yellowish. Indra Gopaha Asya Vasana Rupam, then this mind also becomes red, like scarlet red, like the Indra Gopaha, like an insect called Indra Gopaha. So all these different colors are there. So Vashyakara says, Kvachit Vishaya Vishaya Apekshaya Agasitaratamyam, Kvachit Purusha Vishitta Vritti Apekshaya. So Raga means color, the Tartamyam. So the difference in colors sometimes are due to the different objects, or sometimes the same object can create different colors. So different colors in the mind are created by different objects. So different objects invoke different kinds of reactions from me. Or sometimes the same object also can invoke different kinds of reactions depending upon the mood of the mind. So kvachit vishaya vishesha apekshaya ragasya tartamyam. So sometimes, because of the variety in the objects with which the mind comes in contact, ragasya tāratamyam, the superiority, inferiority of the moods of the mind is established by the object with which it comes in contact. Kvachit purusha citta vritti apekshaya, and somewhere it, or sometimes it is purusha vritti apekshaya. Sometimes the same object can create different kinds of reactions depending on the kind of samskaras that are invoked. And that is why this variety is there. Anandagiri has something to say here on the page 563. Indra gopa upamanena kausumbhasya gatatvat maharajanam haridrayati vyakhyatam. So Vashyakara explained maharajanam is haridra, is turmeric. Could also mean turmeric is yellow. Maharajanam can also mean red, but Indra Gopa Upamanena Kausumbhasya Gatatvat. So Indra Gopa Upamanena, footnote number 11, Nanu Kusumbhe Tachabdasya Prasiddhatvat Tasya Grahanam Kimnasyat Aduktam. So Kusumbhe Tachabdasya Prasiddhatvat. So this word Indra Gopa is well known as something that is very red, I guess, you know. Tasya grahanam kim na syat aduktam syat kusumbham vandishakam maharajanam ityabhi iti asankhi. So, tasya means this maharajanasya. That what is called maharajanam can also be read. So, why not by maharajanam we mean take the color red? Why did Bhashyakara take the color yellow? So, syat kusumbham vandishakam maharajanam ityabhi iti asankhi. The question can be, so word Maharajan apparently is, it can mean turmeric also. It can mean something red also. So why is the meaning turmeric accepted here by Bhashyakara and not the meaning red? Because Indra Gopa, that insect is red, that being the case, the word Maharajana is interpreted as turmeric. Indra Gopa Upamanena Kausumbhasya Gatatvat Anayoho Tulyarupatvat. So Indra Gopa and red are similar, and therefore Maharajanam Haridrayati Vyakhyatam. Not a big deal, but anyway. So because somehow Vartikara must have made, you know, discuss this point. So Tatra Chitta Siranjana Karatve Loka Prasiddhim Darshadi Yenaiti. And so so how the mind can become color with that Loka Prasiddhim. So what is well known among the people as to how a cloth becomes dyed or colored, and similarly also the mind can get dyed, it is compared to a cloth. Uranadityadipadam iti adipadam kambaladigrahasam. Ura means wool, kambala means blanket, so whatever. And so that is how, with reference to this sheep. Manasi vasana vaichitra kim karanam. How come there are so many varieties of vasanas in the mind? So Vashyakara explains, sometimes it is due to the variety of the objects, sometimes it is due to the variety of samskaras which are in the mind. Chitta vritti apeksha, chitta vritti shabdena, sattvadi guna parinama vivakshita. So sometimes sattva, sometimes rajas, sometimes tamas. So same object can invoke different kinds of reactions from me depending upon whether my mind is sattvic, whether my mind is rajogun, has rajas, is rajas, or it is tamas. Depending upon my own mind, the same object can also invoke different kinds of responses from me. So different objects can invoke different responses depending upon the association I have with the objects in the past, or the same object can invoke different responses depending upon the mood of my mind. So says footnote number 14, Sattvadidi taduktam vartike rajasah kvachidudrekah tamasah kvachidichishyade sattvasyabhi tathavutkarshah kutaschit upajayate. So kvachid rajasah udrekah. So somewhere or sometimes it is rajasah. Rajoguna is predominant. Sometimes tamoguna is predominant. Sometimes sattvaguna is predominant. Kvachit means manasi, so in the mind. Okay. So chitta vritti shabdena sattvadi guna parinamaha vivakshataha. Guna vaichitram. So the sattva rajastamas, that combination can create a tremendous variety in the mind, and that's why so many different vasanas are there, or colors are there, responses are there. Then continuing the bhashya, yatha chaloge agnyarchahe bhaswaram bhavade tatha kvachida kasyachida vasana rupam bhavade yatha pundarikam shuklam tadvadape cha vasana rupam kasyachit bhavade yatha chaloke agnyarchahi, like the tongue of fire. So bhaswaram bhavati, how it is resplendent. So how the tongue of the fire is resplendent. Tatha kvachit, kvachit means vishay, kasyachit manasah. So sometimes with the reference to some particular object, the mind becomes bright. So bright like the tongue of fire. Yatha pundarikam shuklam, and just as a lotus, white lotus is white, pundarika is white. Tadvada piche vasana rupam kasyachit bhavati. Similarly also, sometimes the mind becomes white like the white lotus. Now we go to page 565 and go to footnote number 5. Evam prakaraniti ataheva uktam vartika sare. So Vidyaranya Swami, who has written Sara, who has explained the whole Vartika and explained it in brief. So here, apparently Vartika Kara may not have done much, but then Vartika Sara gives us a little more information about this.
Anantakalpo pachayad ananta eva vasanaha. Udaharanamatram tu drishtante rihi varnyate. Ananta kalp upachayat anantaha eva vasanaha. Inasmuch as this jiva has assumed countless bodies. So this fellow goes from one body to the other depending on the karma, depending on his desires. And that is how ananta kalpa, inasmuch as the creation is beginningless, therefore, we imagine that this subtle body or the jiva must have passed through countless bodies from the beginningless time. So, ananta kalpa upachayat, and thus in every body picks up some vasanas. So, goes to the body of the dog or Indra Gopa, all of these he must have passed. He must have gone through the body of the sheep also, and of this Indra Gopa also, whatever it is. And all these different shades he has picked up. Just like the river that begins from the top of the mountain and travels hundreds of miles to reach the ocean. And on the way picks up different kinds of minerals and different kinds of samskaras. And so many other little streams also join
So by the time the river reaches the ocean, it has picked up so many variety of minerals and variety of salts. And similarly also the mind that is passing through so many kinds of upadis over such a long, infinite period, therefore has picked up, you know, the countless different samskaras or impressions.
Ananda kalpo pachayat ananta eva vasana.
Now, that there was a previous birth, the doubts are slowly going away even by the actual experiments. That the psychiatrists with their hypnotism are able to go, you know, farther back in the time and are able to actually make this person contact with the experiences of the past life. That is all because what the way this fellow behaves in this life seems to have no bearing with, you know, with what he has gone through in this life, you know. So the way he behaves now doesn't seem to have any connection with his, they try childhood problem, all kinds of problems they try, but nothing seems to work out, you know. And therefore, these problems are incorrigible. And so this fellow thought, maybe he didn't know that. Nobody ever thinks in West that there could be past birth. Therefore, they always go to childhood and want to get an explanation of everything that is happening to him now based on what happened to him in childhood. And so one very prominent psychiatrist could not work with one of his own nurses, you know, and she was just behaving in a very queer and a crazy manner, and he did all kinds of things, nothing worked, you know. And so someday again she must be having a session with him, and he must, with hypnotism, you know, he was trying to get some answers from her, and all of a sudden something happened to her and this woman, you know, and she went back into the past life. And then this fellow somehow learned, he had some kind of a talent, you know, he must have some kind of insight into things. He was thus able to go back to second past life, life before that, you know. So 2-3 lives and several lives he was able to go through. And now there are so many cases where the jivas, the people, have gone back to their past lives, and that has helped them resolve the things. This is their theory anyway, that if you can relive what you lived in childhood, then that will help you to get rid of things, you know. Then you can see that this is not happening to me, it is happening to that child, I guess. That's the whole idea. And thus you can see that this is all I have carried, you know, without any reason with me, or that there is no reason for me to feel that way now. It was okay. When I was a 5-year-old child, that I was treated in a certain way and I had a reason to respond in a certain way. But now that I am a 25-year-old person, there is no need that I should behave like that. But person continues to behave that way only. Even at the age of 70, he continues to behave like the way he behaved at the age of 5 or 6, you know, at different ages. Because those things are carried forward and not resolved. So now that I see that all these behavioral patterns arise because I am habitually responding the way I was responding as a child, then I can see that it doesn't make sense and there's no need for that. If I do see that, you know, if I continue to see the need, I will never give it up. But then, suppose I see the reason that there's no need for me to now respond that way, then at least I can become objective with reference to these reactions. And so they say, you know, I don't know who has actually gained from what from this, but anyway, I guess something must be happening from this mode of treatment also. I don't have much confidence in this business, you know, because I haven't seen any great results of all this. But I guess it does help to know why my mind behaves in a certain way. It does help to know that. So at least I'll stop blaming myself and I'll stop blaming others also. This blame business, at least I can become free. Then I can realize that the reason why I behave I find my mind reacting in a certain way is because a poor mind had to go through this kind of situations or experiences, and therefore I need not blame myself today, nor do I need I to blame the situation now. That way, of course, it's a great relief. Still, that thing needs to be resolved anyway. But at least a person stops condemning self or condemning other people.
Anyway, ananda kalpo upachayat anandaya vasana. These vasanas are infinite, you know.
And so how many lovers will go back? I don't understand, you know. How long will you go back? Ananda kalpo upachayat. This has been all picked up over ananda, means countless cycles of creation.
Anandahaya vasanaha.
And therefore, these vasanas are countless. And if one has to really deal with every vasana, it is an impossible task, because in the process of dealing with the vasana, you are creating new ones, you know, the very process.
Udaharanamatram tu dushnandehi iha varnyate.
So, subsequently, Vaishyaka will discuss whether should we understand that these are the only modes of the mind. He says, no, these are only illustrations. A few illustrations have been given. So, now, Haridram Vasanam Yadvat Samsargat Pidatam Vrajet. Yadvat, just as Vasanam Samsargat Haridram Vasanam Samsargat Pidatam Vrajet. So, just as when a cloth comes in contact with turmeric, how it becomes yellow like turmeric. Tadvad Naryadi Samsargat Lingam Ragadi Madbhavet. Similarly, also the mind, when it comes in contact with objects of enjoyments, then also it becomes colored like that. Like the cloth becoming colored with turmeric.
Ishat Panduscha Parushaha Syasvata Shveta Kambalaha Tasaishat Shraddhayayuktam Svato Ragadi Bhagavi. Ishat Panduscha Parushaha Syat Svataha Shveta Kambalaha. Shveta Kambalaha, a white blanket or that white wool of sheep. Ishat Panduscha Parushaha. And so Pandu means white. It is somewhat white. You know, actually it is grey but somewhat white. And it's rough, you know, that is how the wool is. Tatha Isha Shraddhayayuktam Svataha Ragadi Bhagavi. Similarly also Svataha Ragadi Bhagavi. Just as there is some whiteness in the wool of the sheep, similarly also, even though there can be raga, dvesha, etc. in the mind, but if there is shraddha, then it gains a certain amount of whiteness. In short, the mind can have this raga, dvesha, etc., but it can also have shraddha. Then mind like that can be compared to the wool of a sheep.
Indra gopo atiriktasya svata eva tathamanaha. Indra gopaha atiriktasya. Indra gopaha is red. Svataheva tathamanaha. So Indra gopaha is himself red. Similarly also mine. Viviktadeshasthasyabhi vishay pravanam kashi kvashida. Similarly also. So mine also can have its own color. Like this insect. Vivikta deshasthasyabhi vishay pravanam kachit. So sometimes the idea is that often the mind is colored by the objects it comes in contact with. Sometimes the mind has its own color. That's why this Indra Gopa is given. Example, like the scarlet red insect, which has its own color. Similarly also mind can have its own color. So Maharajanam Vasaha, where the cloth becomes dyed, whereas Indra Gopa has its own red color, similarly also, that's why Vaishyakara said, the taratamya, this variety of mood is sometimes because the mind comes in contact with objects, like the cloth coming in contact with turmeric. Sometimes chitta vritti apekshaya, and sometimes the very mind has those colors, like Indra Gopa has its own color. So Indra Gopa atiriktasya, he is independently red. Nobody has colored him. Svataheva tathamana viviktadeshasthasyabhi vishay pravanam kvachida. And so therefore we find that even when the mind does not come in contact with any sense object, but because of its own colors, viviktadeshasthasyabhi, even though a person is in an isolated place, in a solitude, still his mind wanders in different sense objects, not because it is presently colored by the contact with the sense objects, but because it has its own colors already. And therefore, even without the contact with sense objects, it can wander into the thoughts of the sense objects.
Agnehe archiryatha bhasvat dhatyabhi tatha kvachita vedashastra vidapyanyaihi bhadyateir syadhyapadravaihi.
So, Agnehe archihi yatha bhasvat dahati api. The tongue of fire has its two aspects, that it is bright as well as it burns. So fire can dispel darkness as well as fire can burn. Sometimes the mind is bright like the flame of fire, sometimes it is burning also. Sometimes it is bright and burning. It may be bright with learning, but burning also. The very learning can be utilized to burn others also sometimes.
So Veda Shastra Vidapi,
So even the one is the knower of Veda Shastra, the Veda scriptures, Vedic scriptures.
Anyaihi badhyate ishyadi upadravaihi.
Even then the mind can be ishyadi upadravaihi. Even though I am learned all right, but when I find someone equally learned or more learned, then I am actually stung or I am burnt by the fire, like the tongue of the fire, with irsha, jealousy, etc. And so both the things are there. The brightness also is there, in as much as I am learned in the Vedas and therefore the mind is bright. But the very same fire burns me also because there is a jealousy of someone else's learning what it is. So just as the fire simultaneously is bright as well as it burns, so also the mind can be simultaneously bright with learning as well as be burnt by the jealousy, etc., that it feels with others. So this Vidyaranya Swami there explains this different moods with the different states of mind.
Sitam bhojam yatha saumyam sugandhi mrudu chasvataha.
Sita ambhojam. Ambhojam means a lotus. Sita means white. Sita ambhojam pundarika means white lotus.
Yatha saumyam.
How white lotus is saumyam. How it is very delicate, tender.
Sugandhi.
It is fragrant.
Mrudu.
Mrudu means actually very delicate. So saumya means beautiful. How it is beautiful, delicate, as well as fragrant.
Janmana eva tatha chittam yuktam shamadamadvihi.
And similarly also, somebody may possess a mind, right from the birth itself. But the mind is possessed of shamadama, all these beautiful qualities. And therefore, that sometimes we find the mind of the people, even from the birth, as very fragrant, and very tender, and very beautiful. It can be.
Tivra vidyut yuthatyantam gharat bhantapanodakrit tatha hiranya garbhasya sarvajna vasana bhavet.
Sakrit vidyuttam, that we'll see. Next one is sakrit vidyuttam. The vidyut means the lightning. And so a flash of lightning, which just appears once and dispels darkness completely. So when you can see in the mountains, particularly when the lightning flashes, all the valleys and everything is momentarily, in one moment, everything is illumined like it is daylight.
Tivra vidyut yatha atyantam ghanadvanta apanodakrit.
Dvantam is darkness. Ghanadvanta is dense darkness. So how the flash of lightning dispels in a moment the dense darkness prevailing there.
Tatha hiranyagarbhasya sarvajna vasana bhavet.
So the kind of mind that Hiranyagarbha has, where there is all the knowledge, that is compared to the flash of lightning. So the vasana of the mind of Hiranyagarbha, who is omniscient, is compared to a flash of lightning. As to how in one thought, so actually Hiranyagarbha sees the entire creation of the whole cycle of creation in one flash. So the story is that how Lord Narayana appeared before Brahmaji, when Brahmaji appeared in the lotus from the navel of Lord Narayana and then performed the tapasarya, not knowing what to do. Then Lord Narayana appeared before him and gave him the darshana, Vishwarupa darshana. So gave him the vision of the cosmic form. Then in one flash Brahmaji saw the cosmic form. Meaning in one flash Brahmaji saw the whole creation at all the times, in all the places. That is the omniscience. So how in one thought everything is illumined, and then that becomes the basis of subsequent creation. And so flash of lightning is the comparison, is an illustration rather, for the mind of Hiranyagarbha, who is omniscient. So this is how Vartikasara explains these different colors which the Shruti gives as illustrations of describing different moods of the mind. Alright, going back to the Bhashya.
So Vashtekara says, yatha chaloke agnyarchahi bhasvaram bhavati tatha kvachit kasyajit vasanarupam bhavati yatha pundarikam shukram tadvapi cha vasanarupam kasyajit bhavati. Now, continuing further. Yatha sakrad vidyuttam yatha loke sakrad vidyotanam sarvatah prakashakam bhavati tatha
ज्ञान प्रकाश विवृद्ध्यपेक्षया कस्यचित् वासनारूपम् उपजायते
यथा सकृद् विद्युत्तम् लाइक वन सिंगल फ्लैश ऑफ लाइटनिंग यथा लोके सकृद् विद्योतनम् सकृद् मीन्स वंस और सो ऑल एनकंपसिंग सो सकृद् विद्योतनम् दैट वन फ्लैश ऑफ लाइटनिंग सर्वतः प्रकाशकम् भवति सर्वतः
So becomes so it illumines everything all round.
Tatha jnana prakasha viruddhya pekshaya.
Similarly also because of the viruddhi, because of the intensity of the light of knowledge,
kasachit vasana rupam upajayate. Kasachit hiranyagarbhasya.
So someone like Hiranyagarbha can have so that kind of a tremendous brilliance that illumines everything in one stroke. See footnote number 10, Atyanda Bhasura. And similarly also, the mind of Hiranyagarbha, which is who is omniscient, can be so bright that nothing else can be seen by anybody else.
Kasajit Vasanarubam. So Viruddhi means Jnana Prakasha Viruddhi Apeksha, Jnana Prakasha Atisha Apeksha. कस्यचित् हिरण्यगर्भा देहे वासनारूपम् उपजायते सो हिरण्यगर्भ एटसेट्रा सो दे वुड हैव दैट काइंड ऑफ वासना यू कैन से सकृदेव सर्वतः प्रद्योतमानम् उद्गच्छति इत्यर्थः दैट मीन्स दैट हिरण्यगर्भ सीज एवरीथिंग साइमल्टेनियसली लाइक द लाइटनिंग इल्यूमिनेट्स एवरीथिंग इन वन स्ट्रोक ओके नाउ गोइंग टू पेज 565 परिमित दृष्टान्तोक्त्या वासनानामपि परिमितत्वं दृष्टान्त दार्ष्टान्तिकयोः साम्यादिति आशंक्या दृष्टान्त दार्ष्टान्तिकयोः साम्यात् दैट एन इलस्ट्रेशन एंड व्हाट इज इलस्ट्रेटेड बोथ ऑफ देम शुड हैव सिमिलैरिटी एंड देयर परिमित दृष्टान्तोक्त्या सो लिमिटेड नंबर ऑफ इलस्ट्रेशन सिक्स इलस्ट्रेशंस आर गिवन महाराजन वासः पांडवाविकम इंद्रगोपः अग्न्यर्चिः पुंडरीकम एंड सकृद् विद्योतनम दिस सिक्स इलस्ट्रेशंस आर गिवन सो परिमित दृष्टांत उक्त्या इन एज मच एज श्रुति ओनली गिव्स सिक्स इलस्ट्रेशंस टू इलस्ट्रेट द डिफरेंट मूड्स ऑफ द माइंड द डिफरेंट कलर्स ऑफ द माइंड वासनानां परिमितत्वम
सो समबडी मे इमेजिन दैट The vasanas are also limited, like six kinds of vasanas are there in the mind, that's what one may imagine.
Drishtanta darshtantikayoho samyat,
because the drishtanta and darshtanta, illustration and what illustrated should have similarity. So somebody may think that the mind has a limited number of vasanas.
Iti ashankyaha na eshamiti, so this ashanka is replied by Bhashyakara. न एषाम् वासनारूपाणाम् आदिः अन्तः मध्यम् संख्या वा देशः कालः निमित्तं वा अवधार्यते असंख्येयत्वात् वासनायाः वासना हेतूनां च आनन्त्यात् तथा च वक्षते षष्ठे इदं मयः अदोमयः इत्यादि नेषां वासनारूपाणाम् आदिः अन्तः मध्यम्
सो देयर इज नो बिगिनिंग नो मिडल एंड नो एंड ऑफ दिस वासनास व्हेन दे बिगिन When will they come to an end? And what's the middle? Nobody can ever determine. The vasana, the samskara, the impressions and tendencies which are in the mind, nobody can ever determine.
Sankhyava,
nobody can count also.
Deshaha, kalaha, nimittam va, avadharyate.
Nor, so, that's a new telephone, you know, we have. So, nobody can ever determine what is the number of these vasanas.
देशः कालः निमित्तं वा अवधारितः
व्हेन विल बी where did I pick them up? When did I pick them up? And why did I pick them up? Nobody can determine this thing, you know. So, desha, kala, sankhya. Bhashyakara knows it all very well, you know, I guess. So, anyway, snivittam va avadharyate. Nobody can determine the cause also of these vasanas. Why is it so? Asankhyayatvad vasanayaha. Because vasana means tendencies, impressions. And so the potential reactions that a mind can exhibit are countless. That's the reason why they always warn that one should never take one's mind for granted. Because it just requires different buttons, you know, and somebody to push the button, that's all. As this person comes and says to Swamiji, I have given up anger. Since last 4 months I have not gotten angry at all. So Swami says, maybe in 4 months nobody had pushed your button, that's all. He says, no, Swamiji. No, Swamiji, I have given up anger. It's not possible, it's just a matter of somebody pushing your button. So I'm telling you, I have not given up anger, you know. So he's just waiting. All that is required is for someone to push the right kind of button. It's amazing, you know, how we can be manipulated. Everybody is just being manipulated because of these buttons. Just as this fan lends itself to be manipulated by switching a button, how the poor thing rotates the way we want. The way you push button also, it will rotate. And similarly also, everybody is subject to being manipulated when these buttons are there. And people know, very cleverly they know, where to push what, you know. If I cannot push, how to make someone else push it and things like that, you know. But anyway, if you want certain reaction to come out, it can always be managed. In short, we make ourselves being manipulated, manageable, pliable, because of these buttons. And therefore, what is necessary to become free is to become free from these buttons, that you can be manipulated by other people and controlled by other people because these buttons are there. So it says, asankhyayatvad vasanayaha. Every vasana is a button. So countless buttons, some predominant buttons are there which we can deal with. And so rest of them, as long as they don't disturb you too much. Sometimes you push the button but a fan doesn't turn, you know. So that's okay. As long as pushing button also, nothing happens, then it's okay. And so then it has come under our control that the world is trying to push buttons, but then you're able to hold, you know, everything within yourself, so it's okay. So asankhyayatvad vasanayaha. Vasana hetunam chanantya, and then the cause of vasanas are also countless. The vasanas are countless, the causes are also countless, you know. And so there are countless causes out there. Tathacha vakshati, in the fourth chapter. Idam mayaha, grihyamana vishayadimayaha, adomaya bhavanatmaka vishayadimayaha, bhavana manuratha, manurajyamah ityasaha. So these two footnotes told us, idam means that which is evident, adas means that which is remote. That means that sometimes this person is influenced by grihyamana vishayadimayaha, so influenced by what is there presently. And sometimes a fellow behaves with no reason at all. And so sometimes you can see the reason why the person behaves in a certain way. Because the object is there, some condition is present there. Sometimes without any condition present, you know, a person behaves in a queer manner. That is because bhavanatmaka vishayadimaya. Which is, you know, something elsewhere, you know. Something that is no relevance here and still manomaya. Because this person is manorajyamaya. All this manorajya. All these kind of imaginations are going on in the mind. And so he sees something that is not there and then he reacts. So there is no way of determining whether something that is presently present, you know, is actually making him behave this way, or something that is some other time. And you are just flabbergasted, you know, as to what happened. You can never understand things. So you are trying to connect the behavior with what is going on right now, which has no connection at all. What is happening now pushes button 25 years in the past. That also can happen. So you can push button of the present, or you can push a button that was there 25 years ago. And the person now behaves as the person behaved that many years ago. And you just don't know, what did you do, you know, or what happened. And so, but anyway, idam mayaha, adomayaha. And so, grihyamana vishayadimaya or bhavanatmaka vishayadimaya. That is how, that's what they say in the fourth chapter also.
Tatra vakyashesham samvadayati. Vasana anante vakyashesham samvadayati. The vasanas are countless. That's what we said in this Upanishad also subsequently.
Says Anandagiri, Vasana anantya tadiya parimita pradarshane parimita dushtanda parigrahasya atatparye kutra tatparimiti arashankya aha. Vasana anantya tadiya parimiti pradarshane. In fact, you are saying that vasanas are countless, and therefore the limited number of illustrations, they do not have the purport in meaning that the vasanas are limited. Parimita dushtanda parigrahasya atatparye. That means that the limited number of illustrations are not meant to indicate that the vasanas are limited. Kutra tatparyam. Then what is the tatparya, the purport of the illustrations that are given here? Tasmad, so Bhashyakara says.
Tasmat na swarupa sankhya vadharanarthaha drishtantaha yatha maharajanam vasaha ityadaya kintarhi prakara pradarshanarthaha evam prakaranhi Vasana Rupani Iti.
Tasmad, therefore, Vasananam Anantya. Since Vasanas are countless, therefore, Nasvarupa Sankhya Avadharanarthaha Dushtantaha. Therefore, the Dushtanta illustrations are not meant to determine the nature of the Vasanas, or that they are limited.
Yatha Maharajanam Vasaha Ityadaha Dushtantaha.
So, all these illustrations, such as the cloth dyed in turmeric, etc., are not meant to determine the nature of the vasanas.
So, this footnote number 4, Napidashtandike Pitamadi, Pitimadi Vivakshanatha.
So, not that the mind actually has yellow color and red color and blue color. So, mind has this kind of color, that is not meant there.
Abhidu vasananam yathokta vasa adivat. Parasparika vaichitra dyotanarthaityavi drashtavyam.
But just as the color can be of different colors, and the cloth can be of different colors, and there each color is different from other colors, similarly also the moods of the mind are also different, and each mood is different from another mood. That's what is intended there.
Parasparika vaichitra dyotanarthaham.
So that parasparika vaichitriyam, each one is different from the other. That is what is meant. The moods of the mind are all different from one another.
Tasmad na swarupa sankhya udharanartha drishtantaha.
So these drishtantas are not meant to say that the mind actually has this kind of colors.
Kintarhi, then what's the purport there?
Prakara pradarshanarthaha. The different prakaras, the different kinds are there.
Evam prakaranahi vasana rupani.
That the vasanas are of this nature, as we saw in the footnote number 5, how the different colors, the different illustrations seek to actually give the different moods of the mind.
So, prakara pradarshanam eva abhinayati evam prakaranayati.
So, this pradarshan, prakara, how different kinds are there, so these are the different kinds of the modes of the mind.
Antyavasana Vishishta Sutropastim Phalavatim Tat Prakarsha Vidhana Purvakam Abhidhadi Yatvidi.
Antyavasana what? Yatha Sakrad Vidyuttam. That was the last illustration. Like the flash of a lightning.
So Antyavasana Vishishta Sutra Upastim Phalavatim.
So that is an illustration of the vasanas, the mode of the mind of Hiranyagarbha. Sutra means Hiranyagarbha. So Hiranyagarbha has this kind of vasana.
Sutra upasthim,
and that is given for the upasana of Hiranyagarbha. This last illustration of the flash of lightning is a comparison of the mind of Hiranyagarbha And this illustration is given in order to actually prescribe the upasana or meditation upon Hiranyagarbha. Phalavatim also, along with the upasana, the phala or the result of this meditation also is given here. Tat prakash abhidhana purvakam Hiranyagarbhi vasana prakash. As to how the vasana of Hiranyagarbha are most exalted, and therefore the exaltedness of the vasana of Hiranyagarbha is first stated, and then the result of the upasana is stated.
Abhidhati yattu ityadina. So says Vashyakara. Yattu vasana rupam abhitam ante sakrut vidyotanam iva iti tatkila hiranyagarbhasya avyakrutat प्रादुर्भवतः तडिद्वत सकृदेव व्यक्तिर्भवतीति.
यत्तु वासनारूपम् अभीतम् अन्ते सकृद् विद्योतनम् इव. सो द लास्ट इलस्ट्रेशन दैट वाज गिवन एंड दैट वाज इलस्ट्रेशन ऑफ अ फ्लैश ऑफ लाइटनिंग. तत्किल तस्य, सो सेज फुटनोट नंबर 6, तस्य परस्माद् जायमानत्वं भास्वरत्वं च श्रुति स्मृति प्रसिद्धमिति वक्तुं किल इति उक्तम्. इज वेल नोन दैट हिरण्यगर्भ एक्चुअली इज बोर्न और इमर्जेस फ्रॉम परमात्मा फ्रॉम द लॉर्ड एंड ही इज कॉल्ड हिरण्यगर्भ. सो हिरण मीन्स व्हाट? गोल्डन और ब्रिलियंट. सो गोल्डन एग. सो दैट गोल्डननेस, द आइडिया इज दैट हिरण्यगर्भ इज रिस्प्लेंडेंट. Because Hiranyagarbha is totally composed of the subtle body, the totality of the subtle body, where there is omniscience. And that's the reason why that the nature of the Hiranyagarbha is compared to the gold, which is resplendent. It is called Garbha, it is called the womb, because it is the potential from which the whole gross creation is going to emerge. So as we said, before any gross creation takes place, that creation is there as a thought in our mind. In the thought itself then becomes objectified as the gross creation. And therefore the gross creation that we see, the cosmic form, is in the cosmic thought form, that is Hiranyagarbha. And so there is brightness as well as potential. Therefore it is called Hiranyagarbha. So tasya parasmad jayamanatvam, that Hiranyagarbha also is called Brahma. And therefore Brahma is shown as appearing in the lotus, which emerges from the navel of Lord Narayana. So Lord is the Paramatma, and from him Brahma appears all of a sudden. And then all of a sudden he has that knowledge. Yo Brahmanam vidadhati purvam, yo vai vedam sap prahinavati tasmai. So one who brings to manifestation Brahmaji and first gives him the knowledge of Veda. And so Brahmaji has, or the Hiranyagarbha, has a knowledge of the Vedas just in one stroke. Bhāsvaratvam ca śruti śruti prasiddhamidhi. All of this is quite well known in the Vedas as well as the śruti. So prasiddhamidhi vaktum kila iti uktam. Bhāshyakara uses this word kila. Didn't decline, tat kila. So sakrut vidyotanam evaiti tat kila hiranyagarbhasya avyākṛtāt prādurbhavatah. Sixth case, prādurbhavatah, hiranyagarbhasya. Hiranyagarbha, who is actually prādurbhavatah, so who appears or manifests? Avyakratat. Avyakratat means from the Lord actually, Ishwarat. So Hiranyagarbha actually manifests from the unmanifest, who is called Ishwara. Taditvata. Tadit means lightning. Like lightning. Sakrudeva vyaktir bhavatiti. That Hiranyagarbha's manifestation becomes instant, like a flash of lightning appearing instantly. So Hiranyagarbha appears, it's not that, so appearance of Hiranyagarbha is instant. Not that there is an evolution there. That the idea is that the totality of all the thought arises instantly. So kamayata. And that thought unfolds itself in the form of this creation, where there is a sequence. But the knowledge arises instantly. It's not that Hiranyagarbha comes to know, you know, in time as to what he is to create. So the creation takes place. There is an evolution, there is a sequence of creation. So that sequence and time is in the process of unfoldment. But this whole creation is preceded by knowledge. And the knowledge must be simultaneous. So it is not that architect keeps on discovering as he builds a building, you know. If he builds something, he says, no, not this way, now build here. So that way it won't work. Although presently sometimes happens elsewhere, not here, but somewhere. So the people go there on the side, no, this wall, remove that, you know. Build something here. But then, generally speaking, when you want to create something, that knowledge must flash in one stroke. And then actual creation will be in sequence, it will unfold in course of time. And therefore, the manifestation of Virat is in an evolution. So from a minutest, subtlest of the element to slowly and slowly grosser and grosser form. But the knowledge that is Hiranyagarbha must be instantaneous. Therefore, it says Hiranyagarbha that represents the totality of all the knowledge arises momentarily from Ishvara, from the unmanifest. Like the lightning appears in one moment and illumines everything. So, vyaktihi ri hiranyagarbhasya tadvasanarupam vyaktihi. Footnote number 1 there, sarvasya vastu jatasya ashrayabhutam vidyut vidyotanamiva sakrudevutpadyade idi anvayamukhena arthaha. Sarvasya vastu jatasya ashrayabhutam. So, that is ashraya or the very locus of all the things. Vidyut vidyotanamiva. Vidyut vidyotanam means like the flash of lightning. Sakrudeva utpadyate. How the flash of lightning appears momentarily, and so also Hiranyagarbha appears momentarily. So very often the knowledge, occurrence of knowledge is compared to flash of lightning. Knowledge occurs like lightning. So you are working on a certain problem and you are struggling with it, and all of a sudden the solution flashes. And the whole problem is illumined momentarily by that solution. So that is why knowledge is often compared to a flash of lightning. This illustration is given also in Keno Upanishad. So vyaktihi bhavati utpanyate. This is how the vasana of Hiranyagarbha manifests momentarily. Therefore, this example is given a flash of lightning. So going back to page 565, says Ananda Giri, the last line, vyaktihi sarvasya vastu jatasya iti sheshaha. Vyakti ashraya hai. Kasya iti apekshayama sarvasya iti. So Hiranyagarbha is ashraya or Hiranyagarbha locus of all that is to be created. Tadiyam iti asya vyakti karanam Hiranyagarbhasya iti. So tadiyam, which comes later, means what? Asya vyakti karanam Hiranyagarbhasya iti. Tadiyam is connected with Hiranyagarbha. So we go to page 563 and read the Bhashya further. Tadiyam vasana rupam Hiranyagarbhasya yo veda tasya sakrad vidyutta iva havai iti avadharanarthau evameva asya shrihi khyatir bhavati ityarthaha yatha hiranyagarbhasya evam etata yathoktam vasana rupam antyam yo veda. Tadiyam vyaktikaranam Hiranyagarbhasya. Hiranyagarbhasya tadiyam vyaktikaranam. Vyaktikaranam. So this manifestation of Hiranyagarbha, that is vasana rupam. So this manifestation of Hiranyagarbha, that is of the nature of vasana. You veda. So one who knows this. So there is in fact, at this point, therefore, this Shruti prescribes a meditation. So one meditates upon how Hiranyagarbha manifests instantaneously and with all the knowledge, which becomes the locus of all that is to be created. So one who meditates on that and realizes that, yo veda, tasya sakrad vidyutteva havaiti avadharanarthau. So that is for emphasis. evamivasya srihi khyatihi bhavati. So that becomes the, just as Hiranyagarbha becomes like flash of lightning becomes known instantly everywhere, so also the Hiranyagarbha's knowledge becomes known everywhere instantaneously, and meditating upon that, the khyati or the fame of this person also becomes instantaneously known everywhere, like the flash of lightning. See, footnote number 3. Khyati hiti drishtam upasti phalam idam. So, upasana or meditation is thus twofold result. One is drishtam, other is adrishtam. Meaning gross and subtle. So, what is the immediate result? And the result that comes later, immediate result is, he gains that fame like the flash of lightning. Adrishtam tu tam yatha yatha ityadi shastriyameva iti dhyayam. Tam yatha yatha upasade tathaiva bhavati. So, as a person meditates, so he becomes Hiranyagarbha, that is adrishta phala, and the drishta or immediate phala is that he gains that glory, or he gains the fame. Evamevasya shrihi khyatihi bhavati ityartha yatha Hiranyagarbhasya. Just as Hiranyagarbhasya khyati, so manifestation becomes immediate, instantaneous, so becomes the khyati of this person. Evametad yathoktam vasana rupam antyam yoveda. In short, this is result of meditation of the antya vasana, not of the previous vasanas. So 6 illustrations are given, and asya shrihi bhavati. So the khyati or the fame of this person becomes like that, provided one meditates upon the last vasana, not the earlier vasanas, Indra, Gopa, etc. So not meditation upon those vasanas, but meditation upon the last vasana, of that this is the result. So this is how the Shruti here illustrates the nature of the mind. Now comes the main topic. So this Purusha, the subtle body, has been now dealt with. Satyasya Satyam. So Satya has been dealt with, we come to Satyasya Satyam. So the Adhyarupa, the superimposition, has been dealt with. Now the Shruti comes to Apavada, the de-superimposition. So says Anandagiri, Vrittam Anudya Anandra Grantham Avatarayati. Vrittam Anudya. Vrittam means what has gone by, gone. Says footnote 14, Ashishu Brahmanad. Then Adeshadidi. So Athada Adeshad, it should be Iti Shesha. Meaning beginning from Shishu Brahmana all the way up to Athada Adesha. So in all that section, whatever has gone by, Anudya reiterating that, Uttar Grantham, Anantara Grantham Avatarayati, the subsequent text is being introduced by Bhashyakara, Eva Mityadina. So says Bhashya, Evam Nirvashesham Satyasya Swarupam Abhidaya Yattata Satyasya Satyam Avochama Tasyeva Swarupa Avadharanartham Brahmanah Idam Arabhyade. Evam Niravashesham, Nishesham, Sopakaranam. So without living anything, Niravashesham, Satyasya Swarupam Abhidaya. Understand that there are two Satyas, Satyasya Satyam. So one is Satya, that is Shashtyanta. Other is Satya, that is Prathamanta. Shashtyanta Satya, or that which is presented in the sixth case, is something to be negated in order to reveal the Satya of the truth which is presented in the first case, Prathamanta. So, satyasya here means that shashtyanta satya shabdartha, which is mithya actually. It is actually called satyam, but it is really mithya. So, what is mithya has been now elaborately or without leaving anything, you know, has been described. Satyasya swarupam abhidaya, having stated the nature of the satya, which is to be discarded or which is to be negated, or from which at least one has to remove the identification. That's all one has to do. So negating does not mean that we have to remove it or discard it or do anything with it physically, except that we have to become free from the identification with it.
So satyasya swarupam abhidhaya yattat satyasya satyam avochama.
And what we said means what the Shruti said, satyasya satyam
tasyaiva swarupa avadharanartham.
In fact, that was said at the end of the first Brahmana. So at the end of the Ajatashatru Brahmana, it was said satyasya satyam. And so the second Brahmana, the Shishu Brahmana, and the third Brahmana, Murta Murta Brahmana, both of them become the elaborate explanation of that expression satyasya satyam.
Iti avochama tasyaiva swarupa avadharanartham brahmanah.
Tasyaiva brahmanah. So this is the Upanishad of Brahma. So swarupa avadharanartham, now to ascertain the nature of Brahman, which has been presented as satyasya satyam.
Idam adeshavakyam arabhyate, athat adeshaha neti neti.
So that is commenced now in order to ascertain the nature of the truth, which was presented as satyasya satyam.
Continuing the Mahashya. Tasyaiva brahmanah iti sambandha, says Anandagiri. Tasyaiva swarup avadharanartham brahmanah.
So tasyaiva, of that very Brahman, to ascertain the nature of that very Brahman.
Then kasmat anantaram iti ukte tad darshyan atashabdha cha apekshitam puran vyakarodi satyasyaiti. So kasmat anantaram iti ukte,
so it is following what?
So this adesha, athat adesha, follows what? Atha and ade ataha.
Atha means anantaram, thereafter. Ataha means therefore. So athata adesha, this athata is a very, very common expression. Athato brahma jignyasa. Atha, ataha. Atha, anantaram, thereafter. Ataha, since there is reason to say something. When something happens, the need for something else arises. So since something has been stated, the need for stating something else arises, therefore this is being said.
So therefore, atha is anantaryam. Okay, so let us read the bhashya. Atha anantaram satyasya swarupa nirdesha anantaram yat satyasya satyam tadeva avashishyate yasmat ataha tasmat satyasya satyam swarupam nirdekshyamaha adeshaha nirdeshaha brahmanaha kahpunaha asau nirdeshaha ityachyate neti neti ityeshaha nirdeshaha. Atha means anantaram.
So in Bhashyakara discusses the meaning, possible meaning of the word atha in Brahma Sutra, and then comes to the conclusion that the word atha there should mean anantaram, thereafter.
So therefore Anandagiri asks, kasmad anantaram?
Thereafter meaning following what?
Idi ukte tad darshan atashabdam cha apekshadam puran vyakarodi tad darshan. So satyasya swarupa nirdeshanantaram,
having actually satyasya swarupa nirdesha, having discussed or described the swarupa, the nature of that satya, meaning the five elements, tadanantaram, thereafter.
So footnote number 15, anantari avadhim. 16 is atashabda vyakhyane. Okay, so ataha means therefore.
Therefore means what? So reason must be given. Therefore, so it's therefore philosophy, you know. So just saying therefore is not enough. But when you say therefore, you must have given reason before. And so Bhashyakara fills it up.
Satyasya swarupa nirdeshanantaram yat satyasya satyam tadeva avashishyate yasmat.
Since now having stated what is satya, what remains to be stated is satyasya satyam. That remains to be stated. So we said that the truth is satyasya satyam. Brahma is satyasya satyam. Is it satya of the satya? So having stated the satya, what now remains to be stated is the satyasya satyam.
So that remains tadeva avashishyate. Brahma tirekataha
na anyad yataha vastu avashishyate. So nothing remains other than Brahman. So whatever is other than Brahman is all been discussed now as satyam. And so what now remains as residue is Brahma.
Therefore, yasmat, ataha, therefore, tasmat, satyasya satyam swarupam nirdekshyamah.
So therefore, satyasya shashtantyasasya, of that which is satya or mithya, swarupam, paramarthikam swarupam. So this gross world is called satya. And what is swarupa? What is the essence of the truth behind this creation?
Nirdekshyamah.
So that is what now we are going to indicate.
How adesha?
Adesha means upadesha.
Nirdesha
also means upadesha. So this is how, as footnote number 3 said, footnote number 10 rather, upadesha. So this is the upadesha. Adesha means upadesha.
Nirdesha brahmana.
So this is the upadesha or instruction pertaining to Brahman.
Kaf punasau nirdesha.
So how is the instruction about Brahman given?
Iti uchade neti neti iti.
Not this.
Iti adeshaha nirdeshaha.
And therefore now, having stated elaborately what is satyam, in order to say what is satyasya satyam, or what is the essence of the truth of all what appears to be real, what is the reality behind all that, is only stated as not this and not this.
This is the adesha or the illustration, rather the instruction pertaining to Brahman. Okay, we'll continue. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashashyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Bhashyakratau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvara Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah Harihi Om. Haitasya Purushasya Rupam Yatha Maharajanam Vasah Yatha Pandvavikam Yatha Indra Gopah Yatha Gnyarchihe Yatha Pundarikam Yatha Sakrad Vidyuttam Sakrad Vidyutte Vahava Asya Shreer Bhavade Yevam Veda Athata Adeshah Neti Neti Nahyeta Swadete Netyanyat Paramaste Athanamadheyam Satyasya Satyamide Pranavai Satyam Teshamesha Satyam Athada Adesha Neti Neti. Now is Adesha, now is instruction. Naiti Naiti, not this. Nahi Etasma Neti Naiti Anyat Paramaste. There is no way of instructing Brahman other than this Neti Neti. This is what the Shruti says, and that's the discussion that Vashyakara has begun on the page 566. Evam nirvisesham satyasya swarupam abhidaya yatta satyasya satyam avochama tasseva swarupa avadharanartham brahmana hidam arabhyade. Evam nirvisesham satyasya swarupam abhidaya. Thus in its entirety,
having stated the nature of satya, which is to be negated, so that satya which is to be negated, which is mithya, yet satyasya satyam avachama, that which is said as satyasya satyam, meaning, so that which is said the adhisthanam for this mithya satya.
Tasseva sarubavadharanatham brahmanahidam arabhyade,
in order to ascertain the nature of Brahman, which is the adhisthanam, substratum of this satya, so which is actually mithya, must call satya. So satyasya satyam, so first satya is mithya, second satya is satya, or first satya is vyavaharika satya, the second satya is paramarthika satya. In fact, this thing gains satyatvam only because of the paramarthika satya, which is the substratum. Or that paramarthika satya alone appearing as this vyavaharika satya. But then as long as this vyavaharika satya, the whole creation made up of five elements, consisting of the gross, subtle and the causal body, as long as that is taken to be real, so long that real satya of the truth remains unknown or hidden, and therefore it is necessary to apavada or negation of this in order to know that satyam. So, yat tat satyasya satyam avachama, so what we say it is the satyasya satyam, tasyeva swarupa avadharanartham brahmanahidam arabhyate, tasyeva brahmanah swarupa avadharanartham, in order to ascertain the nature of Brahman, the truth of Brahman, idam arabhyate. So this adesh vakyam, so this passage or this vakya about the adesh, instruction about nature of Brahman is being commenced here. Atha ataha adeshah, so it is atha ataha adeshah, atha anantaram, thereafter satyasya swarupa nirdesha anantaram, so anantaram, thereafter satyasya swarupa nirdesha anantaram, having instructed in then swarupa, the nature of satya, that is the elemental creation, yet satyasya satyam, so that which is the truth behind this elemental experiential creation,
tadeva avashishyate yasmat.
So having stated or having pointed out all that is within the realm of experience, what remains now to be known is that because of which the experiences are. So that which is experienced is one, and that because of which the experience is another one. So usually that which is experienced is given reality, and therefore that because of which the experience is generally escapes our notice. And so, yet satyasya satyam tadeva avashishyate, since that remains brahma tirekataha na anyat yataha avastu avashishyate. Footnote number 7. So other than Brahman, nothing remains. Everything being pointed out now, nothing remains to be told other than Brahman. So whatever is other than Brahman, meaning whatever is superimposed upon Brahman, you should not really say other than Brahman, but that is just tentatively said. There cannot be anything other than Brahman, because nothing can stand apart from Brahman. Ornaments cannot be other than gold. But still, that is what is superimposed upon Brahman, all of that having been pointed out. And so nothing remains now to be said about things which are superimposed upon Brahman.
Ataha tasmat satyasya satyam swarupam nirdekshamaha.
And therefore, now we are going to instruct about the nature of satyasya satyam, so that which is the truth behind this truth.
Atha, ataha, and adeshaha.
So these three words are there. Atha adeshaha. Atha, thereafter, having described the nature of satya which is to be negated, ataha, since now what remains to be pointed out or what remains to be instructed is param brahma, therefore adeshaha, therefore there is this instruction pertaining to brahma.
Nirdeshaha upadeshaha, adeshaha means nirdeshaha or upadeshaha.
Upadesha and adesha, adesha means actually instruction, or adesha actually means command. Usually adesha means command. So this is the root from which all these various words are derived, but then depending upon the prefix, the meaning does change. Here on the other hand, adesha is interpreted the same as upadesha, meaning instruction. Nirdesha means pointing out. Adesha means command. Nirdesha means to point out. Upadesha means to instruct. So here, the word adesha is understood as upadesha, brahmanaha. Kafpanaha sau nirdesha hai. So what is this instruction pertaining to Brahman? Uchyate, that is being said, neti neti iti eshaha nirdeshaha. This is nirdesha. This is instruction, neti neti. Not na na iti na iti. Becomes neti. So this is the most famous thing. Neti neti has become very, very famous. And so, what is it? Pratar nama pratar bhajami manaso vachasamagamyam vacho vibhanti nikhalaya danugrahena yan neti neti vachanaihi nigama avochahu. Tad brahma, na, tad, no, yan neti neti vachanai nigama avochahu tam deva deva majamachyutam ahuhu agriyam. So, neti neti vachanaihi, that which is instructed by the words neti neti. Atad vyavrutyayam चकितम अभिधत्ते श्रुतिरपि स कस्य स्तोतव्यः कति विध गुणः कस्य विषयः. And so who can praise him, because his attributes are countless, and who can know him, because he cannot be objectified. And so atad vyavrutya, only by vyavrutti, only by negating what he is not, that the Shruti seeks to instruct about him. Now continuing on this page 566, yathokta adeshasya abhava parivasayatvam manvanaha shankade naiti naiti, not, not, not. Where will it stop? The thing is that when actually this negation is done, not this, Brahman is not, 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 then this process of negation, where will it stop? Is there a limit, or Is everything negated here? Yathokta adeshasya abhava parivasayitam. So, tat tat parikatvam. So, abhava parivasayitam. So, somebody here has a doubt that this way you will negate everything and nothing will remain. And thus, by negating not this, not this, not this, nothing will remain. Abhava parivasayitam, which means that this process